Hi, it's Shane with futureproofmybuilding.com. Welcome, and I wanted to talk to you a little bit about future proofing. Really, the point is to build resilient sustainability into the system, which you could argue that we have now, but I don't really believe that that's nearly as good as it could be. And so, really, what's stopping us is our attitudes. We just don't see the big picture. Human beings are not really equipped for this. And I'm going to give you an example here. One of the things that gets in our way is it's really difficult for us to understand something when our livelihood gets in the way, and currently our system is in the way. Here's an example. What do human beings need? We need food, but we're doing things in a way which is kind of destructive. It does provide our needs, but if we look at the big picture, we can do better. We also need water. And you can argue that we're doing what we can to protect it, but in some ways we're also putting this at risk. We also need shelter. And you look at our homes, we could be building for the longer term. Europe is a good example of where they're doing this, and we're not really looking in that direction here in North America yet. And we're using much more energy than what we need. And fracking is something which is giving us a lot of cheap natural gas energy, but as I just showed, it is affecting water for some people. And this is unnecessary. We can get energy, free and clean from the sun. And if we understand a few things, we can also get food and grow at least a portion of it in our homes or at least locally so that we're living healthier lives. And this to me is the definition of future-proof. And so, the way to get there, it's really not that complicated. I'm going to simplify it here. And really, what future proof is freedom. It's your freedom. You're using money as a tool to set yourself free. So the first thing you need to understand is reduce your energy or your water use. And this doesn't have to mean that you're compromising in your lifestyle. Technology can do this for you. And consciousness, being aware of what you're using. The next thing is to reuse. There's technology that recovers waste heat or recovers cooling from air conditioning, and you can capture energy, and you can reuse the heat from water as well. And then the next thing is to generate renewable energy, such as solar or wind or air source heat pumps or, water source heat pumps. And these are what people often think of first, because they're like the sexy new technologies. But really, if you want to be cost effective, you need to reduce and then reuse energy. And if you really look at this, it's completely parallel to using materials. We're taught in school, at least I was when I was a kid. First, you reduce what you're using, then you reuse it if possible, and then you recycle it. So it's a full-on suite of things that you could do. And I want to give you a real life numbers example here, which anybody can do, and this is a no-brainer. You're going to see why. Let's do the math on LEDs. So if the goal is to save money and therefore save energy, then an LED light is much better than solar, a photovoltaic panel for the technical term, and it has a very quick payback and it's guaranteed. So I went to the store, and this was a little while ago. The price of LED lights is dropping rapidly, and I replaced 60 or 360 watt light bulbs in a fixture with $20. So I replaced these 360 watt incandescent bulbs, a technology which is over 200 years old, with 3 9-watt LED light bulbs, which last 30 years, and they use much less energy because they also produce much less heat, which is great because now you don't have to pay to air condition, and that's great if you live in a hot climate as well. So the net energy savings from this $20 investment is 153 watts at any given time that those lights are on, right? So if you wanted to replace that 153 watts with solar technology, and at the very reasonable price, which is around $3 per watt installed now, putting in that 153 watts of solar would cost you $459. So for the same net savings in energy, you are saving $439 to achieve essentially the same benefit. You're saving the same amount of energy. Now, this is going to depend on how sunny it is where you live and how cloudy and which direction you're pointed. The bottom line is that replacing those light bulbs saves you a lot of energy, and it saves you a lot of money. So what's the payback of that? Well, if you were to do a calculation, let's say you own a business and you leave those lights on for 12 hours a day, which, you know, if you're at home, that might not be as much, and you're paying about 13 kilowatt cents an hour, which is about the average, you're going to save 24 cents a day just with those three light bulbs. So if you figure out the payback of those light bulbs is 84 days, or less than 3 months, which in accounting terms is approximately a 400% return on investment once those things are paid off, and they last 30 years. So there's not a mutual fund, there's not a stock, there's nothing out there that I'm aware of, at least, that pays back 400% guaranteed. And this is something that anybody can take advantage of. So, you know, why wouldn't you? So replace those old light bulbs with new ones once they burn out. Don't buy the crappy old incandescent lights. And there's a reason that governments are banning them. It's because of this incentive, and because it just makes it easier for society to move forward. So if you want to learn more, there's examples of this. I have a mailing list, and I wrote a book to explain these engineering concepts in very simple terms so that anybody can take advantage of this. If you want to watch more videos, I have a YouTube channel. I also do consulting, but my main goal with this is I was doing consulting and realized, you know what, people need to understand these things. I'm only working on 10 projects a year, and there are so many people that can actually solve the world's problems. So my goal is to get this information out there, whether it's through presentations or whatever, and create the awareness and a community of future-proofers to help solve the world's problems. And I'd really like to help promote your product or service through futureproofmybuilding.com if you can help build a better world. So thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed this and learned something, please share it. Have a great day. Thanks.